And welcome to the Cleanroom of Fraunhofer CNT, the Center for Nanoelectronic Technologies, a division of Fraunhofer IPMS. My name is Benjamin Uhlig, and today I want to take you through a little tour through our facilities. We are here in the north of Dresden, in the heart of Silicon Saxony. We have about 4,000 square meters of cleanroom equipped with 60 semiconductor processing tools on mainly 300 millimeter silicon wafers. As you will see, we are right in the middle of setting up everything and expect full operation in a few months. The airflow and climate is automatically controlled. Less than 1,000 particles with a size down to 1 micrometer are allowed in 1 cubic meter of cleanroom air. For comparison, an equivalent would be the size of a small pinhead in a large swimming pool. This is important because even the smallest dust particles can change or destroy the later function of the electronic device. As basic substrates, we use 300 millimeter silicon wafers, which is usually for the most advanced devices. To check their contamination level and particle level, we use, for example, such an optical measurement systems. And here we can measure down to a size of 35 nanometer. Again, for comparison, a human hair is more than 2,000 times thicker than this. On our next station, you see the necessary wafer logistics in action. One cassette called FOUP contains up to 25 wafers, and those FOUPs are stored in a large stocker. Everything is tracked digitally in a manufacturing execution system and can be released automatically. There you see a colleague retrieving a FOUP out of the stocker and putting it on another wafer logistics tool, which is there to sort wafers in and out of another FOUP, which can then be used for the later processing steps. Now we pass through our lithography area. As you can see here, the light is different to protect the photosensitive resists used in optical lithography. Here at our facilities, we have an electron beam direct writer capable of providing nanostructures down to 20 nanometers. Here you get a good view on the other side of the clean room. With this infrastructure, we do applied research on a variety of topics like emerging memories, low-power CMOS technologies, or spintronics. As an upcoming field with huge disruptive potential, quantum computing promises significant advances in major markets and applications. And with this semiconductor manufacturing equipment, we want to enable the next steps towards large-scale, manufacturable quantum systems. Here you see one of our newest tools acquired through the Forschungsfabrik Mikroelektronik Deutschland, FMD, by funding of the BMBF. It is equipped with several chambers for flexible and fast material screening, as well as ultra-precise thin film deposition control. Cryopumps down to 11 Kelvin provide the needed ultra-high vacuum conditions, and up to 21 different targets can be used for several applications. We use this, for example, to develop new materials and process conditions for superconducting qubits. This is used in several platforms like silicon spin qubits or superconducting devices. With tools like this, the CMOS compatible infrastructure, equipment, and the network of the microelectronics industry, we want to provide significant advances towards quantum computing in the next few years. I hope you enjoyed our small tour. We will keep on installing everything until the clean room is fully functional again. Stay tuned and follow our progress.